Hi and hello today. We're going to continue where we left off last time. Which means we got some lines to pin. So I haven't set it up yet. So I'm just telling you that. Yeah, I think I'll be less vocal today than yesterday. I mean, I guess I should find my own flow, whatever that is. Okay. Oh, sorry. We are waiting for the thing to get hot enough. Okay. Now I've been doing this hobby electronic stuff for decades now. But only very recently, I actually discovered the magic of flux. Which I know, it's supposedly this has flux inside of it already, but two different things. Yeah, the power of the Church of Flux. Just what? Halfway done. It's probably going to be less wieldy. Okay. This up is done. Why is here? Here. Boom. Another up is still coming. Alright, end of this shot. Alright, and now for the most tedious part of the whole thing, that is trying to fit the ends of the cables inside of this thing. I mean, I know the wire gauge, it's an overkill for this, but hey, this is what I have, I'm gonna work with that. I guess, wish me luck. Now the question is orientation. I'm actually gonna check it on the lamp that I already have here. And okay, it's the right side. Okay, so on this side, I just want the ends. And just to even have this, okay, so hot and neutral. So if you think that you just need to break the hot lid, well, you're probably mistaken, as I have been. I mean, with AC 250 volts, at least here in Europe, you better break both of them, otherwise you get the capacitive coupling, and you know, things like LED lamps or anything that has a switching power supply, it's still gonna work even if the switch is off, which is not nice. Yeah, we don't need that at the moment. So, yeah. Yeah, and I want to actually have the ends somewhere near those metal strips so I can still solder it together. And yes, I pronounced the D in solder. It means the same thing though. Squeezing the cables like there's no tomorrow. Ah, almost there. Yeah, good enough. Just not to... Yay! I switched orientation at some point. Did I or did I not? I mean, now it's on. Yeah, you see, reality is always more difficult than you would think. Let's compare it to the normal good one. Okay. the lettering is correct, then this is like this. Hey, we didn't actually screw it up. That's nice. Yeah. Hooray. Okay. I mean, in theory, I know the shape. I could try to reshape it. Magic. Yeah, we're gonna flood it with solder anyway. Well, with tin, whatever you want to call it. It's actually neither. I mean, it's more than one thing nowadays, so. And it's supposed to have flux in it. Not that that ever works well. Yeah, and I'm not going nuts with just checking the continuity all the time. I guess I find just doing it after I solder this. Yeah, I think that will be good enough. Now this stuff. I mean, it does feel like I'm breaking it, but it's so thick. I mean, overkill. Pretty tight. I guess there's less space on this side. But shouldn't this be symmetric? Hmm. Yeah, I think this is good enough. Now time to solder it. And moving on. I'm just trying to get it closer to where you can actually see it, or at least I hope so. I don't think this is ideal for me. Let's be generous. Should be fine. Let's see. Well, we'll test it for continuity and with an ohmmeter. All right. Time for tests. Okay, this is closed, so it should just work. And it does. Yeah, connection's good. Nothing's shorted. Oh. For completeness. Yep. And yeah, all looks fine. Now it's one thing we should not forget. it to remove the tabs. I guess not too much at a time. Nibble it out. Proper orientation. I think we're going for this pink here. Yes, yes, yes. It looks fine. Okay, of course I did forget putting the sleeve on those, but I mean, nah, we'll just put one over it. It's fine, we'll fix it later. Check it again. Both states. That's hot. Ground. Goes. Okay, now this should be closed, so no connection. Good. This one, the hot one, no connection. And the ground should always stay on. There it is. Okay. I'm electrically satisfied. I think the next steps warrant another shot. See you then. Okay, last step, putting the heat shrink sleeving. Hopefully we'll be able to actually get it over this. I mean, there's always things you forget about, I mean, order of operations. But I think we may just... nope. Let's see. Okay, that's surely going to fit. I'm not sure if this is going to actually shrink fully, but I guess we'll see. And yeah, this is about what? It's over 5 centimeters, so what? 2 inches should be enough. And yeah, so I basically treat these, in these cases, as the structural supports. So getting the cables not tangled would be best. But yeah. Yeah, I think. It's a lot of shrinkage that will have to happen for this to work. I guess we have to try out. No, that's not gonna work. Let's turn the fan off. Now we have a fighting chance. Well, it is shrinking. Yeah, it's always a bit of a... I mean, I should use a torch, probably. Well, a heat gun would be best. I don't have any. Well, actually I do. But not here. Which is essentially, functionally, the same thing. I don't think this is going to get any tighter. Not ideal, but at least on the other side should be much better. I think this is the one that I usually use, and probably have a cut one. Yeah. So I'm going for, again, 5 centimeters, more or less. So, yeah, I mean, it's not ideal that these aren't same length. But am I that bothered about that? I mean, we're gonna connect them with those screw connectors. So I can just squeeze it. And this should hold it here in place, so... Okay, here we go. Yeah, think this is, should be useful, well, usable and useful. Let's get this wired in. No, you don't go. Anymore. So why am I doing it so many times? I basically want the shell here to touch the metal connector part, but not be inside, so you know the screw actually catches on the wires when it's all tight. Okay, I guess that's good enough. And the last one. Okay, should be ready for testing, which actually won't be on the camera because I need the lights to film, etc, etc. Thank you for watching. I know I'm pretty crappy at this whole videography thing, but I mean, if I don't try, I will certainly not get better. And yeah, time will tell. Have a good time of day.